what it's about. There's something evolving. Whatever may come, the world keeps revolving. They say the next big thing is here, that the revolution's near. But to me it seems quite clear that it's all just a little bit of history repeating.
Has always had the biggest, freshest flavor.
The big fresh flavor.
Bring the chewing gum.
Carry it with you.
Bring the chewing gum.
The big fresh flavor.
Bring the chewing gum.
Carry it.
For a rich, replenishing moisturizer that melts into your skin, take Vaseline Intensive Care of yourself.
Play Film 4.
We must always, you know, remember that there is a difference between TV and cinema. And cinema, for it to survive, it has to give the audience something that they can't get on TV. So cinema going has to be an out-of-the-body experience.
Cinema has matured to such an extent as a great art form that now there is there are these homages, these acknowledgements, these cross-references, and they're not in-jokes, they're there to celebrate a great craft.
Before anything else, film is an art form and it's a way of expressing. And the most interesting films in the world, always the films that are personal views or personal interests, or a person has an individual thought that he wants to say about the world.
I'm after something that connects the head and the heart. So, we all want to use our minds when we watch movies, and some movies don't give us any chance to do that.
I just generally think that filmmakers, theatre people, television people, despise and underestimate their audience. Their audiences like to be presented with conundrums and problems. They don't want easy answers.
People want to be told stories. Stories tell us how to live. An association with the hero, a feeling that, well, if they've got out of that sticky mess, then maybe I will. And I think it's that satisfaction often that we want to achieve when we watch a film.
One thing about film is that it's an escapism, and I think it's very important to have escape.
Watching films is about enjoying yourself or just feeling something. In a general term, it's about feeling something and coming away either inspired, you know, sickened, laughing, in love. As long as you come away with those feelings, then something's worked.
Sunday on Film 4.
What's the problem?
I think you know what the problem is just as well as I do.
I don't know what you're talking about, Hal.
This mission is too important for me to allow you to jeopardize it.
We present a tribute to the late Stanley Kubrick.
You're so ugly you could be a modern art masterpiece.
We are here to help the Vietnamese because inside every gook there is an American trying to get out.
7.62 millimeter. Full metal jacket.
I can remember when I was a little boy, my grandmother and I could hold conversations entirely without ever opening our mouths. She called it shiny.
An entire evening devoted to the work of one of the most inventive, uncompromising, and original filmmakers of our time.
That is quite a story.
A tribute to Stanley Kubrick. Sunday from 6. Film 4.
Spectacular cult horror from Robert Rodriguez now on Film 4. Quentin Tarantino and George Clooney star as ruthless killers, the Gecko Brothers, in From Dusk Till Dawn.
Monday on Film 4 at 8:15, Michael York joins Liza Minnelli in her divinely decadent film debut.
I'm Sally Bowles.
I'm Brian Robbins.
For Bob Fosse's potent and evocative chronicle of interwar Berlin.
Oh, right. Darling, what is the German word?
I don't remember.
Cabaret.
Oh, yes.
Oh, no.
Bumsen.
Bye. By my lieber Herr, farewell my lieber Herr. It was a fine affair, but now it's over.
A film that was to change the face of the American musical forever.
You're responsible.
Then at 10:25.
I see everything.
Film 4 Productions presents the television premiere of an uncompromising portrait of Pride and Prejudice, with an acclaimed cast including a cameo from Mick Jagger.
Love your streetwear.
Bent, concluding our tales from Berlin, Monday night, Film 4.
Next weekend, Film 4, our season of daylight robbery begins.
Rock and roll!
A double bill of heists, hold-ups, hijacks, and organized crime. From 10 o'clock every night.
There's nothing that can't be done.
8 nights, 16 films, an impressive lineup of professionals. The greatest minds from both sides of the camera. These guys are dogs. Reservoir Dogs. We know where they got their plans, and we're gonna take you there. We've got a top team taking this baby down. Let me introduce you. Nick, Jason, Dexter, Stephen, Jason, and Baz, aka the cast of Lock, Stock, and Two Smoking Barrels. They're gonna be taking you to the action every night of the week.
But I reckon if we pull this job off, it puts us back on top.
There's a lot of talent.
I mean, is this guy something or is he something?
A lot of trouble.
Five.
There's some real gems in this bag. Hankering for a high.
Old El Paso turns an ordinary meal into something really special. So, if you think of authentic Mexican taste, think Old El Paso. Old El Paso. Fun comes in yellow boxes.
Time is the new name in computer retailing.
At Time, we're committed to making computer buying easy.
It's time for plain English.
Not technical jargon.
It's time we cut out the middleman.
And cut the cost of computers.
So if you're looking for a computer, isn't it time you talk to us?
Time Computer Systems. We're on your side.
I'm here for my 11:30 appointment.
I'm here for my 11:30.
And
11:30.
11:30. I don't want you to be no slave. Work all day, but I want you to
to get an appointment here.
Obviously, we're all overwrought.
NYPD Blue, Thursday at 10 on 4.
And he said to me, my advice to you, just do it your way.
Well, if you're going to write and you want to get something that means anything, write something that's close to your heart, and that's always a good place to start, because you're going to find that something comes out of that instead of trying to, you know, start on a subject that you know nothing about, probably.
I made a short film with a comedic colleague of mine called Stuart Lee. It was a 15-minute film called Cookery for Men on a very low budget. I only had a slightly stretched limo. And a small Filipino boy.
But when you do something like Lock, Stock, or something that's termed as a low-budget feature, is that invariably you've got people putting in their time and effort because they believe in the project, which is obviously a great bonus. It sort of creates a great sort of sense of we're all in this together, you know, we're all going to get this movie made. And once it starts, I mean, what are you going to do? You're going to go home and leave it half-made. You don't want to see that happen. And once you see something development, it's good, and you know that it's fresh, and there's some new energy sort of coming out of the British film industry. People always get on board with that.
I'm still a novice at it, which is why I'm as fascinated by what happens behind the camera as much as in front.
I watched the Scorsese thing, Personal Journey, and it made me love him all the more because he was so unprecious about what he did, and he seemed intent on demystifying it. So a documentary that sort of threw the doors open. And they said that it's possible to make films and it's possible to be involved in them, and it's not a difficult thing. All you need really is a passion.
Paul Morrissey, the great American independent filmmaker, once said to me, the most independent you can get is just going out and doing everything by yourself and do it your way.
Sunday on Film 4.
What's the problem?
I think you know what the problem is just as well as I do.
I don't know what you're talking about, Hal.
This mission is too important for me to allow you to jeopardize it.
We present a tribute to the late Stanley Kubrick.
You're so ugly you could be a modern art masterpiece.
We are here to help the Vietnamese because inside every gook there is an American trying to get out.
7.62 millimeter. Full metal jacket.
I can remember when I was a little boy, my grandmother and I could hold conversations entirely without ever opening our mouths. She called it shiny.
An entire evening devoted to the work of one of the most inventive, uncompromising, and original filmmakers of our time.
It is quite a story.
A tribute to Stanley Kubrick. Sunday from 6. Film 4.
More international erotica now in Film 4's regular naked cinema slot. Critic Anne Bilson introduces the sensuous gothic horror of Jean Rollin's Fascination.
The film you are about to see was made in 1979 by one of the unsung auteurs of French cinema. Unless you spent the 70s hanging around in sex cinemas, or you're the sort of person who naturally gravitates towards the more recherché sections of your local video store, you probably won't have heard of Jean Rollin, because his work combines